Hello, internet, and welcome to Like the Show. You know what it is. I know what it is. Let's just chat it out, guys. Something I'm liking this week is I went and saw As Above, So Below with Robin, and I didn't think it was gonna be anything at all, and it was actually pretty fine. I thought it was creepy and pretty good, you know, whatever. And I watched the Nixon by Nixon documentary on HBO, so two very similar horror films. The Nixon thing's wonderful if you're interested in Richard Nixon. Another thing I'm liking this week is I was hanging out with my friend Tim, and I had a big audition and had to do some characters, and we came up with a bit, which is David Lynch.
Do you have a favorite for Best Picture?
8.5 by Federico Fellini.
Well, there you go.
As a tour guide at Universal Studios, and it's not a very good David Lynch impression, but it is really fun to do, and it's basically just, welcome tour! Nice hat, boyo. Over there is the Psycho's house. My favorite part of the film Psycho's is when the orb rises over the bridge and a man sleeps with a dog who reads a newspaper. So today's guest, really cool dude, Streeter Seidel. He works here with me at MTV. He makes hilarious videos. You might know him from College Humor. You might know him from other things he's gonna plug. Yeah, you can watch his stuff here, and I'm gonna be talking to him right now. So I'm here with Streeter Seidel. Streeter, you work at MTV.
I do.
And
we sit next to each other.
Yeah, we do. We sit like
across
from each other, yeah. And we're always taking each other's cords.
Oh man.
It gets pretty nuts up in here.
It gets crazy.
Yeah. Do you want to talk about this 4chan guy?
I don't know who this guy is.
Yeah.
But I'm a little nervous that they haven't found him yet.
That's true.
He's out there hacking people.
He just runs around and hacks.
And I'll be honest, I don't think 4chan's his real name.
No.
Seriously.
No, because it's actually the name of a website.
Exactly.
Yeah. And we were just talking about how funny it is. The leaks isn't funny. It's not funny that Jennifer Lopez.
Jennifer Lopez
had her boobs out there, and that's not her choice. That sucks. You know, that's not cool. Now, were you ever on it? Did you ever use it? I remember staying away from it because I heard it's like full of.
Yeah. I would get scared because I remember people being like, "Oh yeah, if you go on 4chan, like you'll get hacked."
Well, and they're all
someone will hack you, and I was like, ugh.
And they're all calling each other like. It's just like, oh god.
It's like, let me go somewhere where I can call people that, where I'm like the only one doing that. Is that what you were gonna say?
Oh, you mean America like 10 years ago?
Yeah. I've been called that. You get called that anywhere though. Like, you know, you put up a YouTube video of your like puppy and someone just goes on an angry rant.
Yeah.
About like, your sexuality.
Well, that's like why I feel like it's okay. Like, I identify with the gay cause because I feel like even though I'm a straight white male, I did grow up as a gay teenager because I was called every day. So I pretty much might as well been because I did like nothing, you know, like, and was just like like all the time. So it's
just
like,
from like everyone just out in the world,
just in high school just and like junior high and middle stuff. School and yeah, my parents,
your teachers.
Actually, well, once I quit football and
that was probably a good move for you,
definitely,
honestly.
Absolutely. And the coach, who was like this 21-year-old kid, and this was in elementary school, it was like flag football, was like, that Morgan kid's a and I was like 7.
That was in your scouting report.
Yeah.
Quick off the line, knows his roots, is a
are you playing fantasy
good hands.
Football?
No, I know nothing. Like, I like that. I like watching football, like at the stadium. I like, I like the culture, but like, I'm not gonna like debate players' merits with anyone. I just don't. I don't have time to learn all the stats.
Yeah.
I feel like fantasy football is like as nerdy as playing Magic: The Gathering. Like, it's the exact same thing. You're basically playing a fantasy role-playing game where you're like, I'm the coachman, and I tap this player this week to do battle with, oh no, I've lost.
Like, that's true.
And like, it's the same thing.
So we're gonna play a game called Rant, and in this game, we're gonna rant about things, hence the name.
Yeah.
But we just gotta, like, in the context of a scene, set up something that you would rant about. So I can go first, or you can go first.
How about I give you something to rant about?
Great, perfect.
I'm your driver, okay?
Okay, perfect.
Ooh, looks like a lot of traffic up ahead. Sorry, I took the highway. There's a ton of traffic. We can't get off.
See, this is the problem with people who drive cars. You are never listening to what I say. I get into the car, I say, take this specific route. I have my GPS up, and you go, no, this way's better. Then guess what happens? We go that way, and it's not better. And you know what? Because you're an Uber driver, luckily, I can just reply to the receipt and get like $30 taken off of it, and you'll get in trouble. So f you, this is my rant, I'm done talking.
Why'd you say this is my rant?
I'm sorry, sir, we're not selling coffee to people who have beards.
Hold on a second, that's crazy. First of all, beard people love coffee, all right? Look at the big coffee cultures in our country. You're talking about Seattle, you're talking about Portland, lots of beards up there, even San Francisco, lots of beards of both kinds, of the facial hair and the fake wife, because you're hiding your true sexual desires, all right? Now, for you to make that sort of policy strikes me as, I want to say racist. Let's classify beard people as a race, and I'll call you a racist now, because you're denying me service simply because of the way I look. What if it were people with shaved heads, or people with brown eyes? You know, am I just supposed to go by the whims of your discretionary customer policy? This is ridiculous. The Yelp review I'm going to leave is going to be strongly worded, long, and I wish I could give you 0 stars, but I'm forced to give you 1 simply due to Yelp's stupid and idiotic star policy. Good day, sir.
Wait, before you go, I have to take off my veil.
You have a beard.
Dun, dun, dun.
What a weird game.
That was super weird. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
You can follow Streeter here at Street Seidel.
And
this has been like the show.
Well, you should plug your own thing.
My own thing is, they passed on it. All right, well, this has been Like the Show. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, if you like it, you know, I'm on Twitter, @TotallyMorgan. I'm on Tumblr, Instagram, whatever. You can subscribe to MTV on YouTube here and comment and let us know if we should keep doing this show. It's been kind of remote silence out there. Just let us know if you're enjoying it and if we should keep plowing ahead. I'd be interested to hear from you. This has been Like the Show. And then, ow, I didn't.